Hello, everybody. Hail Mary, meet everybody. It's MicheleMarieDalene. Today, it's actually technically Monday morning. I slept most of the day. And I wanted to show you the new iRig Pre I bought. And to explain that there's a glitch with this, I took a look at the inside to see if I could figure out a way to fix it. And I can't, because I don't have a surface mount rework station to fix it. What it is, it still works for its intended purpose. You're just going to take the battery out, oh, it's going to kill it. When you put the battery in, you see the 48 volt plus light comes on, even in the off position. And you turn it on to regular on, the green light goes on like it should. And then you turn on the 48 volt plus, there's no change because the 48 volts plus is being passed to the microphone to the boost converter all the time. So you take the battery out. Obviously, turn it off. I did order another one, and I should be able to pick it up this afternoon and see if the second iRig Pre has the same glitch. I will probably be using this one as a spare if the other one works properly. And I'm not going to return it because you can see insertion marks from my tools to get this thing apart. It's held together by a single screw right between the two 9-volt battery terminals. Once you take this off, and then this XLR plug is held in place by two screws as well. And it smells like somebody overheated something inside with the soldering iron. It does not smell healthy. It definitely smells like something with the acid or with the non-lead-based solder has done something nasty to PC board. Definitely smells like something got burnt. But it does work. But I'm going to get the other one, and hopefully it works. And then this way, since I know somebody wanted one of these last time, they stole the other one from me. Since it is working, I might just offer this one to the pawn shop as... at least I can say it works, or maybe I might just pawn this at the soup kitchen, or maybe, just maybe, it could be fixed, if anybody has any ability to do surface mount technology repairs. I might just offer this as a sweepstakes prize. As I said, it's for an iPhone, iPad. It can work with many Android phones. However, some Android phones may not automatically select the external microphone for recording videos. If yours does, then you're all set. You just plug this four conductor plug into your Android phone and you can record video with it. Just make sure to pull the battery out when you're done, or you're going to end up with a dead battery. If you want to go with nickel metal hydrides or NiCads instead, if you want to not have to worry about the battery going dead and flinging it in the garbage, that's fine. You could even add, in fact, I was going to consider doing that. I gotta be honest, it might be a little hard to do it. I was going to consider adding a simple little on off switch that is between here and here that cuts out the battery circuit as a second safety, which I might still do that. It wouldn't be too hard. This was plastic. Just get a simple little switch. Find a position that is not going to be, because you got this battery here, just to show you what I'm talking about here. If you put the battery in here, okay, I know, see where it goes right here, and I can see where it goes. There's going to be a little bit of room in the back here on the side here that you can add a separate little slide switch if you don't want to do the SMT stuff. I don't blame you. Personally, it's a nightmare, but okay. So, works something's rattling around in there. I think it's a piece of plastic that's broken loose. That does work, though. I paid a little less than list price for it, so I don't expect it to be in the best of condition. It is considered new, but trust me, the packaging I got was packed well, but the actual retail box definitely looked like it had been resealed, as if it was a store return and the individual probably didn't tell the store that it was defective. Definitely looks like it has a manufacturing defect in it. So, you know, it happens. It's a good spare, though. If someone steals the other Ivory Pringle order, which is supposed to be working, then I have this as a backup. So, great to have a spare. Always great to have spare equipment, as we discovered in the last few months. By the way, the PowerVolt 122T rebuild, we're still having the same identical problem with the drive, even in self-diagnostic mode. So that tells me something on the PC board has gone south. So yeah, we're going to have to replace the drive mechanism. Maybe next year when we get the next Richard's rebate, and next November if there is one, and get a new part and put it together. I was just watching the very first episode of episode one of The Apprentice today, because I wanted to see how Donald Trump was, how he dealt with the show, because I'd never seen The Apprentice. And it looks very interesting. One of the assistants on the show, was it Barbarossa? She actually is being, Donald Trump has offered her a position to work at the White House, I believe, as political spokesperson for the White House, and she was very excited to see that after serving for 13 years with The Apprentice. And then, of course, Nigel Farage is going to be working as a European ambassador for the United States. Good luck, Mr. Farage. I'm proud to see you have been appointed to something after UKIP, and I'm very proud of you. Also, Rennes, Priebus, and Mr. Bannon, will be working for the White House as well. Just like in The Apprentice, Donald Trump does not surround himself with buffoons. He looks for the best he can get, and uses and has them work for his enterprise. And he's working the White House as if he was working his company, which is he's trying to appoint the best people he could find to do their jobs and to help him out with the work. So, congratulations from me. Now, unfortunately, we do have some bad things to talk about, but they're not really yet too bad. But we do have to bring them up. Is while we've had a nice, wonderful holiday from the BS of budgets for November, December is, well, the usual baloney. So that's all I'm going to say right now. I definitely think that this more than likely is that the cell phone is going to be going the way of the dodo. The home phone is not being modified. We're going to keep the home phone as it is because we use all three phone lines for call-in shows. And to me, as a business level, that's a big deal. Because having three phone lines means I can have three calls, three conference calls, interviews, and things like that. And that's a very big thing. It's a very powerful tool for our work. And that's what we're going to do. Unfortunately, all those years, the year of stress has really done a number on me. I said my cortisol levels through the roof so bad that some clothes don't fit very well anymore. And so we are finding ourselves having to reevaluate our wardrobe. Ooh, that's not so nice. That's what happens with stress and age. I'm getting older, and so I'm slowing down anyway, and it's not uncommon for a lot of people. And I'm sure Donald Trump himself could probably see something somewhere, even though he still, and he did, he pushed himself to superhuman feats during the election campaign. I'm amazed at how many times he would go between states, not necessarily next door to each other, in his Trump plane, and would go ahead and go to the different countries and do all this stuff. And he would be there doing five or six, sometimes as many, four or five different rallies in a single day all over the country. And still doing news interviews and magazine interviews. That sounds to me is that's a man who seriously is dedicated to the job at hand. I say to you, congratulations. I hope you really seriously do your own job of being a successful president, or you're fired. Seriously, you know, you got 4 years, like you said, to get things done. If people like what you've done, we'll appoint you for another four. If you don't, well, you're fired. There you go. So, as far as all the Democratic thugs that are upset with Donald Trump's being president, guys, look, let's just back away from the violence for a little bit, okay? In 4 years, if he doesn't do what you want, that's when you get your Democratic Party to get better organized with a better campaign platform and give it another go. You guys have got to realize that's how this country works. This is not a third world country where we have revolutions to choose a president. We have a system, and may not like the system. I may think the system is kind of stupid, but you know what? We have a system, and it's been around for 200 plus years, 240 plus years. Let's use the system that we have, that we've created, to choose the best president. Okay? If you don't like it, well, you got always have the chance to come up with a good platform in 4 years, and it's gotta be bulletproof, or Donald Trump is gonna really have done something really wrong. I don't think he's gonna do anything wrong on purpose, but sometimes his ego gets in the way. He's not the only one with ego. I got an ego too, but the problem is I try to keep my ego in control, because, you know, here I am doing these videos. I'm going out there every day. I'm on camera every day. You see me more every day than some people see the grandchildren. I have a lot of youngsters. I have a lot of millennials that watch my channel, at least in passing. I want you to know that I am extremely proud of everything that you have done to make this channel great. Because you are the key to anybody's success is a customer. And if the customer is not happy, it's not going to matter what content I put on, because it's not going to get out there, is it? I need to focus on what you want. So, I've always said, and I will continue to say, please contact me through all the various means to tell me what kind of content appeals to you. I will do what I can within my means to make it happen. It doesn't mean it's going to happen overnight. Okay, because right now, like I just said, November spending is over. We have enjoyed 2 weeks of, I wouldn't say laissez-faire spending, that wouldn't be accurate, but 2 weeks of being able to have some extra cash to spend some extra time, have some extra fun. I treated Dory to a nice pizza dinner. I went ahead and I bought some new sneakers. They will be here by UPS Smart Post by Tuesday. And I also ordered this iRig Pre, which unfortunately has got a manufacturer's defect on it. But it does work. But I'm not impressed with the way it works. So, I think We're going to fix that. Because that thing smells burnt. I don't know what Eric did to this, manufacturing this. I opened it up inside and it smelled cooked. Like somebody burnt a part on this unit. It's, like I said, it still works, but it just smells bad. Okay, and you gotta take the battery out when you're done with it. But, oh wait, yeah. Why do I have some new tape drive working? The 120T. Works very well, thank you very much. It is faster than the Powerboat 122. And it's kind of cool seeing the little tape elevator go up and down as it grabs tapes and it grabs them in both directions because you have two slots in the back of one and two. You have five and seven, or six and seven. So it's like a double door elevator, kind of out the doors. So, or more like a free elevator, okay? In other words, if you want tape one, the elevator goes up one, grab one, slides in, goes down to drive level, there it is. Pushes it through to the drive mechanism. The drive does like it does in the Powerboat 122T. Shook, loads up. Now, it does a lot more pre-testing of the cartridges, but it seems to be more thorough. Then, when it's done on MTX, I can type in, I have to unload first the drive, okay, or I have to eject the drive on the MT command. And then that puts it into the elevator. It's called the picker, by the way. Oh, it's just called the elevator because that's what it does. It elevates. Okay? And then it loads the tape into the elevator. And then when you say unload into a certain slot, I can say unload into, like, slot six. So let's say slot six is empty. Let's say the tape was originally was in slot one. So go ahead and load it into slot six. Really neat. Really cool. The drive is physically a little tall. It is taller than the Powerboat 122T. But it is physically much, much smaller footprint. And given the way my computers are set up in the house, that's not a minor issue. That's a big issue. Because you got a tape, if you get a computer tape drive that's too freaking huge, it's going to take a lot of precious real estate. Mm-hmm. But we're not going to use that necessarily with the Mac because one, the Mac is kind of, if I'm using the IO SCSI tape module that was created by a third party, which I usually use when I want to do TARS. It doesn't have any way of dealing with the autoloader section. So I was just like with the Powerboat 122, I was always sitting there pushing buttons to get the tape to load up from the front panel. So I'd rather be able to slide the tape in into the drive. The original drive that I bought, the HP Sure Store, was used. And unfortunately, the drive did not like my Mac. Don't know why. And I do know what I did know when I took the thing apart was the original plastic of the drive itself, of the case, where the screws held the plastic bezel in front, had cracked off on one side. And I couldn't easily find a way to fix that. So what I did do is I took that drive and I fixed that. But at first I tried to fix it with crazy glue. That didn't really help. So unfortunately, since someone stole my electric drill, my drill press, the other option for me to do would be is to drill and retap a new screw hole, which is something I would have done anyway, considering the fact that given where the screw hole was, on the edge of this very brittle plastic. Remember, after so many years, plastic gets really brittle and breaks really easy. So if you can fix the plastic by doing that way, that would have been fine. But I couldn't really easily do that, so I just had to work out a way of fixing the other stuff. So I did manage to fix it, and I put that together, and it works. But the original drive that was in the case, the original HP Short Store VSA, which is quantum branded VS80, which is the same brand as the Dell DLT-110Ts, did not like my Mac, no matter what I did. But it doesn't mind my Linux machine. So what I did was, since it was closest to the color of the Linux machine anyway, is I took the drive out of the case, okay, and I placed that drive into my Franken computer tower, the big homemade 80 to 80X form factor conversion. That looks better there anyway, because it's white. It's gray instead of white, so it looks like it matches better. The original 110 DLT drive I placed into the HP case because it was a drop-in replacement. Everything fits the same. The SCSI connectors are the same, everything. But the one thing I did not hook up on purpose because I realized I didn't need to was the SCSI drive selector. Push buttons on the back for channels, for IDs. I didn't need to set those up. So I left the drive set for drive ID. Hold on, man. I'm on my brain thinking this out here. Yeah, I think it's set for SCSI ID 6, which was fine because it wasn't being used by anything except for my tape drive, my scanner, which is on a different channel, which is also 6. So obviously, if I accidentally plugged into the same channel as my SCSI ID or my scanner, it wouldn't show up. I thought your SCSI ID was 5. No, it's not. Okay. So anyway, right now it's working on my Mac and it's happy and I'm able to back up and restore. Even if I do have to manually swap the cartridges out as they get full, but that really isn't too much of a big deal because right now my computer is pretty small. So, so we have ascertained that indeed it is the VS640 board that is bad. And that drive is going to cost a lot of money to buy the part for. And it's not going to happen anytime in the near future. Maybe in a couple of months, maybe another year from now, we'll probably have another one. I'm thinking definitely by that time, we might be going with consider it going with an LTO system. But I would think I'm going to get something similar to they do make an LTO version of the Fast Store, by the way, LTO1, but that's kind of old school. I'm thinking about going finding this LTO2 tape library. In by that time, LTO2 should be relatively hard to find, and maybe go for LTO4. Anything that can plug into SCSI or even into external SATA would be a good candidate for average applications. So that's what we're going to work on. Now, I'm still going to need your help financially, but I don't need to rehash it. The video I shot last November is still quite pertinent. We are still not on Section 8. We still do not have a job yet, but I've been watching The Apprentice. As I said, one episode gave me an idea, which is maybe it's time I find another way to find a day job. Okay, the problem is unlike what I see on a reality TV show, I don't know what kind of day job I can find here in Winsted. When Donald Trump gets appointed and sworn in on January 20th, we're going to see a lot of beginnings of a lot of positive changes. One, small businesses are going to start tons of people I talked to in small business are already getting excited. With Obamacare, which is a major hurdle for them to hire full-time because of the cost. companies may very well be reconsidering hiring people very soon for jobs. Second of all is, if he does manage to get companies to come back to the United States and establish, reopen their shops here in the United States so we can work, that would be great opportunities for so many people. For me, maybe it might be in a packing department. It may not so much be making electronic circuit boards or making furniture, that kind of stuff, but maybe possibly in packaging and inventory. Something where my smarts can be used, but also that would be a lot less dangerous. Like working around, like for example, in a furniture factory, working around wood lathes and routers and table saws, man saws, and things like that. But still, might be able to show my skills in maybe even clerical area. It's because I do got a lot of smarts. I just I don't have a lot of things that I think an employer would consider a saleable market. But let put it this way, guys. I have to consider that. There will be opportunities in a few months' time for people to get out there and show them what they've got. Maybe I might just offer it as a contest. You want it, and if you make a donation, okay, not quite a contest, but how about this? You make a donation to our site of monthly of $20, $20 a month on Patreon. I will send you the first one to give me $20, we'll get this unit for free. It works, but it definitely has something wrong with it. But it does work, and you can enjoy it. And as I said, so the first person on Patreon who makes a donation to my campaign, going to www.patreon.com/BICHELA, a monthly $20 contribution. We'll get this, okay? So the first person who signs up and donates $20 monthly as a monthly recurring Patreon money, I will gladly send this out to you. But you have to do at least $20 on Patreon. If you don't do $20, you can't enter the contest. If you do $20, your name will be in the contest. And the first person who does a monthly $20 gets it. No price. No charge. No fees. No nothing. And especially it would be wonderful if somebody has the ability to do SMT repair and maybe they can find out what in the heck is wrong. It looks like somebody put too much solder somewhere, probably caused the switch to short, which I'm sure is what it is. The problem is because the wiring is so small, I looked at the PC board, I couldn't easily see the problem. But you know what? I'll be honest when I say this. I am not an electronic. I am not that good when parts this teeny. My right eye is far from exemplary. My left eye is great, but my right eye is a fucking mess. You already know this. So, the point is that's the deal. So, first one signs up for a monthly $20 a month gets it. There. And that will get you something to work with. You just can, it supports, well, it's supposed to support 48-volt phantom-powered microphones as well as non-phantom-powered. So it will work with condenser microphones. It will work with amplified ribbon microphones. And, of course, it works with standard dynamic microphones such as the Pile PDMic 1, the Shure PG-30. PG-38, PG-48, PG-58. And of course, the S-757, S-758 as well. So you can, and we can work with an SM-11 lapel microphone if you want one. But you gotta buy that for like $100. Okay, it goes on your t-shirt, like in my case, I'm wearing a t-shirt. That also works with that as well. So you won't have to walk around like a, with a microphone like this on my table here. You could just use, instead of using a microphone like this, you can use a little clip-on lapel microphone. And if it's a condenser-based microphone, it supports 48-volt phantom power. It will provide power for that too. So it's a great option for you, and it's... but like I said, the only thing I can tell you right now is it works with dynamic microphones. I can't tell you anything about the 48-volt phantom power at this point. So, definitely... Oh yeah, you're going to have to supply an enable battery. Sorry, I took out the battery. I'm going to use this for my other iRig Pre when it comes in. And maybe when the new one comes, if it comes with a good 9-volt battery, I might just throw in one of these other 9-volt batteries. These are good batteries. They're just a little bit old. But right now, when you're on a fixed income, you got to deal with what you got. These got plenty of juice left. They're from smoke detectors. Which... something we're going to deal with. Okay, now the next thing is I still would like to have more volunteers and staff. One of the things I'm looking for is more people who have some audiovisual experience and editing experience to help out here at the studio. Because the fact is, yeah, I want to expand this network. I want to expand this program. I want to go further than just me and the couch talking to you. I want to have more new faces and new investigative reporting being done. And I want to have more people who are passionate about their work in the media field. So, yeah, if you're interested in volunteering here at the North American Snow Green Palace, I can definitely use your help, especially editing. Some of you guys are pretty very creative, and I know we can do so much more than we're doing with your help. I'm not really that kind of creative in the visual arts field, but again, remember, I'm legally blind, so yeah, you know, there's kind of a limitation of how I see the world is very different than someone who's really, really extremely got good sight, is highly visual, highly knowledgeable about composition and compositing and all that. You guys know what you're doing. You guys are skilled. You guys got a lot of talent. You, I know, can knock them dead. So, I'm looking for that person. It's a voluntary position. But the good news is, if we can get this program to start turning a profit within 6 to 9 months, and we can start bringing home a profit in the sense of people on Patreon making monthly contributions, or maybe finding products that we can sell that is going to make money. We can start paying staff. That's what I would like to do. And then the end goal is I still would like to get the money to start a fully licensed, fully bonded AM radio station here in the United States, as well as possibly having an FM translator station as well. But Winston, let's be honest, is so small. This town doesn't need an FM station. And Winston's FM radio stations are, the bands are so tight, there's just no room for another station right now. So I really would like to focus on the AM bands because there's a dearth of good material on AM. And I would like to cover that area. And not only just talk and yak news and weather, but also to cover other things as well. Having music, local musicians, creating music programs, all kinds of wonderful options. This is your chance to do great things. By the way, I found out something that's greatly... I did not expect this. This is really super glue. This is the generic glue. And I found out that this... Remember those little Walmart sneakers that were kind of separating? Well, I was able to put this onto the sole and onto the leather, and I was able to fix that shoe. So now the shoes are repaired for the time being. My new sneakers are going to be here probably by Tuesday. My Eric Pre, the second one's going to be here today. Then I'm going to go back on Tuesday and get the other sneakers. We were supposed to go shopping on Tuesday, me and Mickey's manager, to get some clothes. Unfortunately, I don't really have the money for that right now. But I was going to go to Walmart and get cat food, and I priced it. 30 pounds is still... You think it's worth it? Well, how much are you charging for it? $19 to 30 pounds? How much for 16? 10. Oh, God, Michelle. This is a no-brainer. Look at it this way. If you're going to get 16 pounds, it's going to cost you 10. And 30 pounds is going to cost you... So just trigger. Take it and multiply it by 2. What's 16 for... times 2? 32. All right. So what's 10 times 2? It's 20. So... Here's the deal. You're paying how much? They said 19 for 30 pounds. You know, I think it's really kind of hard to say which is cheaper. Really, do you need 30 pounds of cat food? You're not feeding the outside cats right now. No, not. Okay, so maybe I can get away without buying cat food. Because I need to save my money. Because we're going to be buying some of the domestics I needed to buy, I was going to buy with my regular checking account. And given all the situations with the budget, I think you're right, Lum. I think we're going to have to just tell my case managers that we're not going to go to Walmart this month. But instead, we're going to go to our local in-town store and pick up a 16-pound bag of capital for the same price, $10, right? Okay? $10. It tastes like $1 a pound. Is it? It is. Yeah. Okay, so 16 for 16 pounds. Yeah. But, I mean, in one sense, it's going to be less stressful because you can go... It's a regular grocery store, so if you want to get groceries, you can get groceries. I can get groceries, right? Exactly. The other thing is, let's talk about the weight. I don't mean weight as in W-E-I-T, although I'm thinking about that too, right? I'm talking about weight as in W-E-I-G-H-T. After the year of, from last November to this October, I put on a lot of weight, okay? Really, I'm not going to lie. I confess that this is my own fault. Of my own words and my own deeds and what I've done and what I failed to do. And you know, the thing is stress really takes it out on you because it's not, it makes you feel, especially when you're going through as much as stress as I have for all those months in a row, it makes you feel really, really low in self-worth. And the excessive stress, even if you didn't change your diet, the cortisol level goes, and that causes your body to do all kinds of nasty things to itself. And then you start to put on those pounds. And so now I got the equivalent of maternity fat on me, so to speak. Especially in the caboose. I have to work that off. I have to find a way to get that out of my body. And the first thing I'm going to do is something that, like Marina Messenger said, is take it easy. Don't get all stressed out, okay? Because Mother God knows what you need. I got to keep reminding myself that because sometimes I forget. Yeah, you do. And that's, I think it's one of the reasons why you're having all these problems is because you tend to forget that. Oh, Mother God, help me. I am so fucked. Oh, yeah, it's true. It's true. I'm not out of the hole. But with as many people who participate in this contest, if the first one that signs up for the $20 monthly recurring donation, you will get this, okay? That's like I said, that will help a lot. $20 extra. And of course, the more people that sign up, the better. Okay? Seriously, guys, $20, it's nothing. I mean, for a lot of you guys, $20, you guys want to see me make money. You know, even you tell me, you said, let's have an auction, let's have a show, let's have a giveaway. Okay, I'm going to look to see if I can find a few more things that might be a little more exciting to give away. I got one, what, since you might be canceling it anyway. What about the BlackBerry Bowl 9900? I haven't decided if I'm canceling T-Mobile yet. But that's a good question. Would anybody want a BlackBerry Bolt 9900 with the extended runtime battery that has been treated well? It's still locked to T-Mobile, but it is a very nice phone. It's for its age. I'll think about it. Now, the IRIG pre-adapter. Oh, yes, I was going to show you something with that. Unfortunately, I don't have it plugged in, right? It's that if for some reason you got a ceramic turntable and you want to connect it to a magnetic phone hookup, that there's a simple adapter you can make. Now, I looked at the schematic where this circuit is made from, and this is made exactly to the exact same capacitor specifications as the original circuit. Now, unfortunately, it's also very delicate, so let me just show you what I've got here, okay? Here I have the colors are a little off. Sorry about that. I made this out of scrap parts. These are brand new 100 microfarad capacitor. Those are the exact same value as used in the SAF24. They recommended, several people on the internet have recommended that you should use 47 microfarad. I didn't have any 47. And the original SAF24 schematic shows 100 microfarad. So that's why I chose these. Now, because these are standard ceramic disc caps, these will not degrade over time, so you will be able to use this for decades. And what it has is this plugs into your preamp for your magnetic turntable. White is obviously right, and yellow obviously is equivalent to your red or left. Oh, it's a red that's right. And the white that's left. Well, whatever colors you choose, try to stick on the same colors on the other side. Okay, then on the back here, you have your ceramic disc is wired in series. So here's the output coming from your ceramic turntable. It's going through the capacitor, and then of course it's connecting to the center conductor on each channel. So it's actually very simple. If you only have a monaural amplifier, only have one speaker channel to deal with, you only have to deal with 100 microfarad instead of 2. If you got a stereo system, you're going to want to deal with the 2. Okay? Very simple design, very simple. And then, yes, I did test it, and yes, it works very well with my pile preamp. And my preamp doesn't seem to mind it at all. The original SAF24 schematic shows that for the magnetic turntable hookup, the center conductor goes straight to the first grid of the 12AX7. And when you got the ceramic, it goes through first the 100 microfarad capacitor, and then it goes to the grid of the 12AX7. So yeah, it's simple. It's a capacitor dropper, but it provides enough isolation that it works. Also, you can use other capacitors as well if you want to try to fine-tune the sound. Certain capacitors, for example, can be used to make the sound, fix the tonal range. This is called filters. You can actually start using this as a filter circuit. So you can go ahead, change the right cap, and you can amplify the low end, boost the low end, and maybe kind of notch out some of the high end. And remember the RIAA curve, it's like this. All the deep bass, okay, response is really seriously muted. It's in the cellar. And the reason that is because in the RIAA curve, it's so that the grooves don't get too wide. Because things that have a lot of heavy bass, the grooves will be enormous. So what they do is they boost, they cut significantly all the low frequencies. And then at the 1000 hertz cross point, that's straightforward, that's not modified. The higher frequencies are boosted a lot. This is on the recording side. Then on the receiving side, or on your turntable, the RIA preamp does something like this. All the low ends are significantly boosted to bring them back to what they consider normal. Then that boost slowly returns again to about 1000 hertz, which at that point, the 1000 hertz is neither boosted nor cut, just like it was originally in the recording. Then when you get to the above that, you start to see the graph. So it looks like this. So when the record, it was like the EQ was like this. And now they play it back, the EQ is like this. What, the 1000 hertz, so it's the cross point in both. So that's, so yes, if you seriously want to really boost your own bass response prior to your preamp, choosing the right capacitor will actually allow you to do that, and you can still make it sound really good if you want to tweak it. It does not distort my preamp with my ceramic turntable cartridge. My ceramic turntable cartridge works very good. Since I'm going to be using the same circuit inside my power amp, the SCF24 anyway, I didn't mind making this because we're going to be using the same thing in the SAF24 for the ceramic preamp circuit. So this, all the differences is right here is where these wires are, as we will cut these wires here, remove the plugs, and properly wire them to the grids of the 12AX7s. And the other preamps over here will go to the second terminal strip, which will go to the tubes directly. So those will be ceramic, and then the magnetics will come just be connected by another power strip down here, and they will be both screwed and mounted into the chassis. So in essence, I really made it apart from my amplifier preamp, and I was just trying it out ahead of time. In fact, the amplifier preamp circuit that we're using, the two 12AX7s, we are going to make it, but we're going to not use 12AX7s. Well, we could, but we can also use 6N2s. 6N2s, which has got the same pin out as a 6AX7. It's going to allow it to run on 6 volts. And then we have, I'm going to be using a solid state vibrating power supply booster that brings it up to the 230 volts for the B plus supply. That's something I'm going to work on in a few months' time. I say a few months because, honey, I got a lot of other projects on my list, which I have not only, I have made a lot of moves to get things done, but I've still got a long ways to go. What about the Canse eye drops? Well, you know, I'm going to be honest, I say this to you. The Canse eye drops, the right eye, still shitty. My left eye is still good. So I'm going to try to keep going up with the eye drops. But you know what? I don't know if I'm going to be able to buy them every month. None of them will start doing other things. And then we also have to deal with the T-Mobile thing too, which I haven't figured out the best way to deal with that. Originally, I was thinking about is I already pay T-Mobile in advance $100. This month, I got to pay T-Mobile Frontier. Next month, I got to pay T-Mobile. And then after that, I got to pay Frontier. So I'm only going to be a month in arrear between the two bills, between each one. That's not a long-term solution. That's just a temporary solution. There's got to be a better way to do it. That's the reason I'm going to work, and I have to work on getting this program, this channel, off the ground and making some money, okay? Because you can't do that forever. Okay, that's asking for a colossal disaster. Well, how about this for an offer? What? Our donation? We can go ahead and offer the Powerball 122T. $1,000 monthly donation. Well, no, just $1,000 donation. Okay, let's hope I can remember that. You donate $1,000 and I will give you the Power Vault 122T reassembled with free shipping, because after all, you give me $1,000, I can cover any shipping on that, right? This drive is colossally huge. It's a big 2U rack thing. It is a 19-inch rack device. And, yeah, I think that might go. But I don't know how many people will buy it. I don't know either, but you can get one cheaper, obviously, if they bought one outright. The whole idea is to, one, let's get some of the stuff out of the shop here that isn't doing us any good. I could buy the part to fix it. This is like $60, but there's no guarantee that it's going to necessarily be a long-term fix, because the part that I'm going to be buying would be a used part from another seller. So there's a chance that the part could stick out bad and we would have to go ahead and replace it again. So again, if you want to fix it, maybe if you got to, again, it's all service mount components. If you have service mount skills, you guys can probably fix it yourself. If you're, I know there's a lot of smart people out there, you can do it. Okay, I'm not going to demand anymore. So $2,000 cash outright. Patreon. Okay, send me $2,000 cash. I will ship it out your way. The first person to send me $2,000 cash, it's yours. No strings attached. Just be aware, it does not work quite correctly at this point. And there's definitely something wrong with the board. If you want it, that's what you do. $2,000 US. And it'll be for you. It holds 8 cartridges. It has a barcode reader on it. And it's SCSI wide LVD SE. And yeah, definitely. It's a solution to the problem. I get some assets to help to fund upgrades to the studio. And of course, I get some equipment out of my shop. And that is going to make a big difference. And same thing with this. $200 monthly, $200 a month donation. Even though this is not in pristine condition by any stretch of imagination, it does work. I've tested it with standard dynamic microphones. It works fine. It definitely smells like it needs, like somebody burned something on it. Like overzealous Chinese soldering person kind of got a little clumsy, but it does work. So again, if you are creative, you can fix it yourself. And yeah, you can see like in the picture here where the switch says on, you see the red and the green light go on. It's the green light, red light also stays on when it's off. So see, that's why you gotta take the battery out. Really nice device, really cute, very functional, and it was used for many times. This one I've never used yet on the field, so if the new one is in better condition, because I ordered the one from another seller, that's a massive, major, big, so as many of them, hopefully that's going to work better than this one, and we'll be all set to go back to work. I haven't gotten the other audio cable yet for the studio work, which is a disappointment. However, we will get everything together. I promise you that. And just take it easy and we'll work our way out to the solution. But for now, I want all of you guys to have a nice day. Could you tell them something about the weather for next week? If there's anything really specifically that stands out that they need to know. Next week we might see some snow after Thanksgiving. Nothing major at this point because it's so far out. I'm only going to say this much. It looks like we may get maybe 2 to 3 centimeters of snow. There'll be some snow showers. Nothing really seriously major at this point in the forecast. However, we do know that, as Adapt 2030s point out, this, that there has been a lot of snow falling in places such as, where is it, one person? Norway. Sweden. Oh, yeah. Sweden got buried. Oh, yeah. They broke records. Same thing in other countries, Scotland, too. Wales. Yeah, you got a lot of snow out there, according to Adapt 2030. So, things are changing. So please prepare, have an emergency radio in hand, a flashlight, and if you radio uses one of these guys, make sure to have a few on hand. Don't forget, if daylight savings time was not too long ago, time to change the batteries in your smoke detectors. Best to do that before they start beeping you to death. I do recommend that strongly, to change the 9 volts so they don't go meep, 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 meep all the time. They're there for your safety. Please use them for that reason. Treat them well, and they will treat you well. And in case of a fast-growing fire, like a grease fire in the kitchen or a mattress fire in the bedroom, for smokers, it's really possible to have a mattress fire if you get clumsy smoking cigarettes in bed. Please don't do that, but you know what? And of course, with the holidays coming, people are going to be setting up garlands and decorations and stuff in their homes. And some people get crazy, insanely wiring up extension cords and don't consider electrical safety. This is really a bad time for fires, especially with Christmas trees. It's getting to that time when already I'm seeing Christmas advertising starting to show up on my phone, so I know that Christmas is not too far away. And I kind of got my early Christmas present, the PowerVolt 120T DLT 1 loader was a very early Christmas present for me. I wanted one of those things for years. If I didn't have someone steal my original IRA Pre, I wouldn't have had to buy a second one. And if this one was not had a manufacturer's defect, I wouldn't have to buy a second one. Third one. I'd say I got a third one on its way right now. So this was, I'm not going to return it because this has got toll marks on it from me opening it up. So I don't think I can get my money back, and it's not worth it for the $29 because then I have to ship it back. And I could contact the seller, but because if he wants it back, I would have to say to him, sorry, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. But if the new one, if it ever turns out to be defective, that will be going back right away, because I'm going to tell the seller right on if it works or don't work. And, are we going to do a video today at the soup kitchen? Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Really not too sure. I'm just starting to calm down from all the stuff of the election and getting a chance to kind of, we're going to start focusing on doing the other things that we were doing for a long time that we deferred because of the election. And, there we are. So, that's it for now, guys. You want to say anything? Just be aware that as winter comes, it's, holidays especially, some people get a little bit crazy in the stores and things. That's coming up next week. It's Thanksgiving. Was it Black Friday? Yeah, that's what they call it, yeah. So, and doorbusters and all that. Just try to keep it sane, okay? Okay. And don't forget that November 8th of this week is the Soup Kitchen's Thanksgiving dinner. They always do it 1 week before Thanksgiving, so it'll be on November 18th this week. I think it's Thursday. I think so, yeah. Okay, and Christmas is their dinner is going to be on December 23rd. And don't forget, Michelle has got the convocation coming up on, another reason why she's got to keep the team working. You're right. She's going to be having a convocation December 21st. December 20th, actually. Because December 21st is... So December 20th at 7 p.m. Eastern Time will be the convocation. So December 20th or midnight Universal Coordinated Time will be the convocation. So that will be coming up, and we'll post a reminder notice a little bit before that time. So you will know ahead of time. Sounds good. And of course, that's free to anybody to watch. Absolutely. Anybody can watch it. Are you ever going to try to do it outside? It all depends a little on so many factors. I would love to do it outside, but because of when it is, it's in winter. It's the first day of winter. I don't think it's going to be able to do it outside. Last year, it rained. And it was windy as hell. And it was windy. So we couldn't do it outside last year because it was just too unpredictable. Couldn't light any candles. I got a whole bunch of candles ready to go for this ceremony. So if we do get some good weather, we will definitely want to do it again if we can do it. Maybe, just maybe this year, we might have luck doing Mabon. That would be kind of interesting. Mabon is officially the end of your season. And then, of course, you could do... I'm doing all four seasons right now for the United States. So, yeah, I can certainly do Mabon. And it's not really my personal favorite, but it might be easier to do it outside than trying to do it outside during Yule, which might be snowing, it could be raining, it could be windy. I wouldn't mind the snow part, but I don't know how the candles would feel. Especially if it's windy. Oh, they'll blow them out for sure. They'll blow them out for sure. Alright, so any comments, suggestions, grapes, concerns, kudos, whatever you want, let me know in the comment section below. I will do my best to answer your questions. I had a person that asked me some technical questions. I answered them for him. From Italy, he was asking about SCSI. I hope that the information I gave him is going to be of help to him to solve his computer problems. That's the kind of stuff I do know. If I don't know it, I will research it and try to find out the answer for you. Alright? So for now, talk to you soon. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, everybody.